27,000 people live in North Peckham, a concrete complex of walkway-lined estates plagued by crime and unemployment. For the sake of security, people prefer to live behind boarded-up windows, denied daylight. 40% are denied work. Task force treatment was supposed to stimulate employment, training and enterprise. In North Peckham, it's flopped, according to local Labour MP Harriet Harman.
It hasn't created one single extra job in this area. It's raised a lot of desperate people's hopes that there might be more jobs in this area, only to see them dashed. And I think really at the end of the day, what we can say is it's been a cynical public relations exercise to make it look as though the government cares about unemployment, when as far as this area is concerned, they just don't.
Task force cynics say that given the cash, Southwark's Labour Council could do better. The task force itself consists of three civil servants installed in a Rye Lane office to coordinate Whitehall departments, local authorities and the private sector. When?
The bandwagon has started to roll now. In January of this year, we had two projects approved. We now have 11 projects approved. We're not simply interested in spending our budget. I don't think that would impress anybody. We're here in a very difficult area, at the sharp end. We're interested in leaving structures behind as well.
A year ago, Employment Minister Kenneth Clark went to North Peckham to see what could be done. When he goes back next week, he'll only be told what's happening. There are plans to convert blocked-up garages into workshops, plans for a cooperative shop, all others have been vandalised out of business, plans to improve security, training initiatives are underway. But the community, according to local councillor Danny McCarthy, expected special attention to produce special results.
The local community doesn't believe that the task force actually really means what it says and are actually prepared to put their money up front.
When did you expect things to happen?
Well, within a couple of months we expected things to happen, because Kenneth Clark and Sir George Younger both gave us the impression that they were going to do things, cut red tape and do things quickly, and they haven't.
Kenneth Clark has another year to meet his own targets, but if he can't produce results in North Peckham, can he offer hope to inner city areas without a task force?